Google Keep. I love it. And every week it seems that I find something else to love about it. For example, I was at the library last week and I took a picture of a book. Okay, it was a recipe book. I found a recipe that I liked going to a potluck and I thought, yeah, this might be neat. So I took the picture, as you do. But when I get back home, I found something that I can do in Google Keep with that picture, which is Google Keep will take that picture and turn it into text for me. It's really cool. I think it's a secret hidden feature. Let me show you how it's done. I'm gonna hop at my desk and show you on my desktop how I did it. You can do it on your phone, but it's a whole lot easier for me to show you on the desktop. So let me go. Here we are in Google Keep, and as we can see, we are in my groceries label because everything here is labeled groceries. What I'm going to do is create a new label though, and I'm going to click edit and then simply type in my label recipes and then click done. As we can see, I have a new label here called recipes and I'm going to click on it, and we can see that I have no notes with this label yet because I just created it. But I'm going to create a new note. It's not going to be a list note. It's not going to be a note with a drawing. It's going to be this middle one, a new note with an image. I'm going to click on that. And what I'm going to do is pick the recipe that I took a picture of from a book at the library. I'm going to click on it and then click open. We can see that Google Keep is thinking about it. I've got the little spinning thing up there, and voila, here it is. Chipotle chili sloppy joes. And I'm going to scroll on down, and we can see those three little dots here that says more. I'm going to click on that, and I am going to select this. It says grab image text. Now watch the magic that happens. Voila. Everything that I took a picture of up here is now translated into text that I can easily edit down here, which means I can do things like, hey, I'm gonna copy that, cut it out and make it my title. If there's anything here that I really don't want, like that, for example, I can simply delete it. But wait, my friends, there's more. Click on those three dots once again, it says more. And there's another wonderful thing that I can do. I can copy this directly to Google Docs. I use Google Docs a lot, and we can see that it's thinking about it. It's copied it to Google Docs. Now let me open that doc. And if you work in Google Docs a lot like I do, what a great treat to have any notes that you might happen to take for work or for lectures or anything else, recipes, and have everything that you've done converted right over where you can edit it and do with it whatever you wish. And as long as I'm here in Google Docs, there's one other thing that I want to show you, and this is something new that got added last month that I personally think is terrific. If you go up to Tools, you'll notice that Keep Notepad has been added here. So let's see what happens when we click on that. Your Keep Notepad will come up right to the side of your Google document. I find this is really handy for a lot of different reasons. Let me show you one. You can actually do a little review. I just deleted the picture and now I can see, did this really translate as well as I think it did? And do a back and forth check on how well it did. There are other uses for this, of course, and maybe I'll get around to showing them to you in a video in the future. So stay tuned, please subscribe, hit that subscribe button, and we'll continue the conversation. Thank you for watching.